Hi, everybody. I'm Bill Sanders, and this is Watch Art Sci, the Art and Science of Watch Collection. Today, we're going to take a look at Michael's truly magnificent collection. And I think when you see it, yeah, you're going to agree that this collection is really amazing. So let's get started. This first one here is a Longa, Richard Long. And it's a time only. I got a center seconds, got the flipped it over on the back. You can see it's a wind up because there's no rotor there. And to me, this is about as close as you get to a perfect watch. The kind of watch you have a hand wound, time only, it's got the center seconds. I've got on my FP Jorn, Chronomet Souvenir, and it has small seconds. I like it okay. I don't use seconds one way or the other, but overall, I sort of prefer, if you're going to have a second hand, I like the center seconds, and this one has it. I didn't have a close-up of it, but there's some really nice engraving on the balance cock that you can see up there. It's about around 1 o'clock on the right there. Platinum, really a gorgeous watch. This next one is a Wooten Lannen. This one's called a 217 QRS. And Michael had a real interesting set of interactions. And he showed me a picture of both the blue and the red. I'm not sure whether he was able to switch them out or not. But that red, I really like that red dial on there. You have on this particular Wooten Lannen, you have the hand date right around the center. Then you have the Arabic numbers around that. And then at down below, you have a small seconds at 6 o'clock. This watch is another hand-wound one, and one of my very, very favorite watches. Love this watch. Beautiful watch. Great big balance wheel. If you take a look on the right there at around 4 o'clock, you can see this giant balance wheel. Kari Wooten Lannen uses those. Plus, he uses the 2.5 hertz movement. Gorgeous, gorgeous watch. He's one of the best. All right. Just keeps getting, doesn't stop. Just wonderful. So Laurent Ferrier Gallet Square. It's a very hard one to photograph, this particular one with this color scheme and so forth. But they're really beautiful watches. I mean, I've tried some on, and they're really gorgeous to look at. They have this calmness to their design that I like a lot. And then in the back, this is an automatic, but they use that micro rotor up around between 2 and 3 o'clock there. Very, very nice watch to have. All right, moving right along. This next one is another A. Longa, and this is the Datagraph Flyback. There was an interview, I think it was in Hodinkee or Hodinkee, whatever you call it, with Philippe Dufour, and he was asking what did he think that the best sort of, what do they call it, what he referred to as serial produced as opposed to handmade and so forth. But he said he thought it was this, the A. Longa Datagraph Flyback. This would be a heck of a watch to have. Beautiful watch. Looking at the movement, this thing is a knockout of a watch. To me, I have a sort of, I'll call it a sort of a chronograph. Well, it is a chronograph. It's a Mono Retropont. But if I had this, I don't think I'd need any other chronograph ever. I really like this watch. All right, this next one is a Patek Philippe 5170 chronograph. This is another chronograph. And this is really another just beautiful watch. And looking at the movement in the back, you can just, it looks like sort of almost like poetry. I love the way this the movement looks, the way the instead of having these big plates, they have these really elegant bridges around for all of the gears and the different types of movement in there. This is another, just it's a great watch. This is, they have complications and they have grand complications, and I'm not sure exactly how they decide which is which, but this one they consider one of their grand complications, the 5170. Neat watch. All right, here's another Boot & Lannen with the small seconds. And again, it's hand wound. It's got the great big balance wheel on it. And what this watch has is one of the things that Kerry Boot & Lannen has really won a number of awards for was design. And part of it is that if you, the guilloche on this is, he's got three types that you can see just at a glance. One, you have sort of the scallop guilloche coming out of the middle, and then you have the sort of a waffle shape over the small seconds, and then around the sides, you have the hobnails. I mean, you got everything. Gorgeous watch. The hands are, they're called apple hands. They have those big round things at the end. And they really do help in, they were developed originally to so that you have the little skinny hands. You can't see the time, but those big apples, you can. Another fabulous watch. Now, here's another Elanga. And this one, Michael said when he saw this, it came out in honey gold. This is a hand wound. Again, my favorite kind of watch. And he said he had to have it, and it really is a beautiful watch. This is the their 1815 model, and I really like this watch a lot too. And now it's got the small seconds at 6 o'clock, whereas the Richard Longa had the small seconds, center seconds. Gorgeous, gorgeous watch. Love it. All right, here's another Elanga. And this one belongs to Michael's very fortunate wife. This is a Doppel Federhaus, and again, this is a hand wound one, and it's got a lot more going on here. You have the sort of a small hours, I guess, not real small, but smaller hours over at 9 o'clock. Then you have the great big date. And then along the right side from about 1 o'clock down to 4 o'clock, you have the power reserve indicator. And then you have the small seconds around 5 o'clock. This is a beautiful, beautiful watch. I love it. You have this great big plate, but you do have, you can, but you can clearly see the balance cock that's engraved and then the balance with that. My Beauvais has that great big plate. And like I said, I like the little bridges and smaller plates better, but this one, this one is really a gorgeous, very interesting watch. Now here's another one of his wife's watches, his wife's watch. This is the Cartier Balloon Blue, and Balloon Blue was best known because the Duchess of Cambridge, forgot what her name was. Anyway, she had one of these, and she was waving at some place, and somebody spotted this Balloon Blue, and they have different kinds with it, including the ones with the in-house movement in it. And this is a cool watch. It's got a solid back, so it wasn't anything to see. It's an automatic. That's another, I mean, for that's a very popular watch for that women like to have. Finally, this is is the third watch belonging to his wife. It is Patek Philippe Nautilus 7008. Now this one has a mother of pearl dial. It's got 50 diamonds around the bezel. And it's there's, I tell you, this watch, it was a very nice one to have. A great big old bracelet on it and a big gold rotor in the back. This is a very nice watch. This is a, how can you look at a watch like this? This is a good everyday watch. Boy, it's a good all the time watch. I would agree with that. Anyway, well, listen, here we get to a point where, what would you recommend? Well, I'd probably recommend, I don't know, FP Journe, I suppose. It's always something nice to have. And a Langenheim, and I like the Langenheim, and I like the Rolf Lang both, because they're both handmade. I think those are the ones that I think always add something. Of course, Voutilanens are too, and there are quite a few of those in the collection. So I this is one of those wonderful collections that you do look at and you say, well, doesn't need my advice. And I think this is certainly the case. But you have some ideas that might be a nice addition to this. Please put them in the comments section. And until next Friday, this is Bill Sanders for Watch Art Side, the art and science of watch collection. And as always, this is an invitation to subscribe if you like it.